Welcome to Bio-Rad's Risk Calculator Training. The Risk Calculator generates a risk assessment report. The following series of videos explains the different elements of that report. We'll begin with the concept of percent unreliable. We define an unreliable patient result as a result with measurement error that exceeds the required quality. We will refer to this quality requirement as the allowable total error, or TEA. Let's imagine that a lab is testing patient samples. Each vertical line represents a patient result. During the testing, an out-of-control condition occurs. All of the patient results after the out-of-control condition are affected. The results with red asterisks fail to meet the quality requirement and therefore are unreliable. The percent unreliable depends on the TEA, the bias and imprecision of the test method, and the size of the out-of-control condition. Suppose TEA is 4.5%, lab bias is 0, the test method CV is 1.4%, and the magnitude of the out-of-control condition is a 2.2% shift upward. In this case, it can be determined that there is a 5% chance that the patient results are unreliable. Let's graph this. The x-axis represents the magnitude of the out-of-control condition. Different magnitudes of out-of-control conditions will be associated with different percent unreliable results. So, we need to look at a range of possible out-of-control conditions. The y-axis represents the percent unreliable from 0 to 100%. For an out-of-control condition of 2.2%, the predicted percent unreliable is 5%. Let's look at a larger out-of-control condition, say a 4.5% shift upward. With the larger out-of-control condition, we would expect more patient results to be unreliable. In this case, the predicted percent unreliable is 50%. Now let's plot the percent unreliable for this out-of-control condition with a 4.5% shift. Let's take a look at a negative out-of-control condition, say an 8.7% shift downward. In this case, the predicted percent unreliable is 99.7%. This is the point for the percent unreliable associated with an out-of-control condition of negative 8.7%. We can continue to compute and plot the percent unreliable over a range of possible out-of-control conditions, producing a curve. In this case, the curve shows the percent of unreliable patient results produced over a range of out-of-control conditions for a lab test that has zero bias, a CV of 1.4%, and an allowable total error requirement of 4.5%. This percent unreliable curve appears here on the risk assessment report. We hope you've found this tutorial helpful. Continue your training by viewing Part 2.